Namaste student, welcome to stats class. We are on the 8th chapter, 5th unit, that is inventory theory. And last session we completed with the theories of this particular concept, and also I have given the formulas where we are seeing two kinds of problem, that is model 1 and model 2. And in that I have told that model 2 we take only if we get shortages. If we get shortages in the problem, then we should go with the model 2 formulas. Otherwise, we need to go with the model 1 formulas. So, firstly, we need to see the problem. So, here we are in the first problem. Now, read the problem here. A manufacturer has to supply 12,000 units of a product. Per year. You have to see always orders, whether your orders are per month or per year. This is per year. The inventory holding cost is ₹0.20 per unit per month. The setup cost per run is 350. Setup cost is 350. Here holding cost is 0.20. Now, what you have to see initially? Now, supply. What is that supply? Supply is nothing but demand. Now, write the solution here. Now, you have to write what are the things are given in the problem. Firstly, we know that supply. That is demand is equal to. It is 12. Now, we have written here demand 12,000. Firstly, then you see there the inventory holding cost. What is that holding cost? What is holding cost? The holding cost, carrying cost, storage cost, or maintenance cost. We call it as, that is C1. We call storage, maintenance, holding, and carrying cost. Storage cost, maintenance cost, holding cost, and carrying cost is nothing but C1. We know that value of C1 is 0.20 per month. See, this is very, very important. We have to see C1. We always need to see first C1, whether it is for per year or month. It is per month. So, if C1 is per month, then nextly we need to see demand, whether demand is per month or year. But here demand is they have given per year. But we always need to convert demand. We have to convert demand according to holding cost. We are not allowed to convert holding cost according to demand. No. We have to convert always demand according to holding cost. So here demand, this is per year. They have given per year. Now we need to convert that demand into per month, because our holding cost is in month. So, firstly we need to see whether holding cost is per month or year. If holding cost is per month and if it is demand for per year, we have to convert demand into per month. If for example, this is per year, this is per month. Again, this only we have to convert for per year. Now, it is per year they have given, we have to convert it for month, means what we need to do? 12,000 divided by 1,000. So now we get demand per month is 1,000. If we need to convert, for example, 120 is there per month they have given. Per year we need to convert into, means 120 into 12. If you want to convert into year, we have to multiply with 12. If we need to convert into month, we need to divide it by 12. Here we need to convert, it is the year demand they have given 12,000. When we convert it per month, we get here 1,000. Now, nextly we know the value of C1, that is 0.20 per month. Then you read. And the setup cost is per run, it is 350. Other things are, it is not necessary to observe that whether it is per month or year. Only two things, that is C1 and demand you have to observe. And you have to always convert demand according to C1. you are not allowed to change C1, we have to write as it is what they have given. We have to change demand. Now it is 350. What is setup cost? Setup cost, reorder cost or procurement cost? It is C3. It is C3. So C3 is rupees 350. C3 is rupees 350. Now see that, determine optimum lot size. What is that optimum lot size? That is EOQ. Optimum lot size is EOQ or EMS. Reorder time. Reorder time. That is, what is that? T0. What is the formula for reorder time? Q0 by R. This one. Reorder time. Time means T0 formula we need to take. Frequency of replenishment. Replenishment what? How many number of times we will fill? We will refill the order which is already used. So replenishment, number, frequency, the time, that is number. Then we need to take N0 formula. What is that N0 formula? That is 1 by T0. What answer we get? That we have to divide. 1 by T0. Then minimum average cost. Minimum average cost is formula 2, C1, C3, half root. So these are the formulas. If you see the table there, which model 1 table, first 4 formulas. Usually we get only first 4 formulas. Be thorough with, at least you be thorough with these 4 formulas. Easy it is, be thorough with these 4 formulas. Now how we can decide whether we need to go with model 1 formula and model 2 formulas? Please take your formula that where that table you have written. There see model 1 and model 2. As I said, we are going with model 2 if we get shortage cost in the problem. Now, do you have C2 or shortage cost? We don't have shortage cost. Shortage cost, penalty cost or inability to meet demand. No. If we do not find shortage cost, we are not going with the model 2. Then you have to see only the formulas of model 1. You have to see only the plus of model 1. If they mention shortage cost, C2 if we get, then only we are going with the model 2 formulas. Now here we need to go with the model 1 formulas since we don't have shortage cost in the problem. Since we don't have shortage cost in the problem, we have to go with model 1 formula. Shortage cost is C2. And now we'll solve the first one. What is that? Optimum lot size. The first one, optimum lot size, that is nothing but EOQ. EOQ is equal to, what is the formula? 2C3R divided by C1. Divided by C1, then 2 into, what is C3? C3 is 350. Into demand. Demand is 1000 per month, which we converted, divided by C1. Divided by C1. What do we get as C1? C1 is 0.20. Now, multiply and divide. Multiply and divide. When you multiply and divide it, you will get as 35 lakh. You will get a 35 lakh. 2 into 350 into 1000 divided by 0.20. Then if you take the root of 35 lakh, you will get there 1870.82. So this is